Hello students, welcome back to your English class. I hope you all are keeping yourself safe and taking care of yourselves. Today we are going to read the diary of a wonderful, wonderful author, writer who has been given Padma Shri for his contributions to children literature. Yes, we are going to read a short monsoon diary of Ruskin Bond. Take a look at these beautiful hills. What do these hills
As I walked
show
home
you?
Last night,
this is Ruskin Bond's
I saw
voice.
A lone fox dancing in the bright moonlight. I stood and watched, then took the low road, knowing the night was his by right. Sometimes when words ring true, I'm like a lone fox dancing in the morning dew.
This is Ruskin Bond himself.
1980, I moved into this particular flat. But I came to Missouri in 1964 after spending 3 or 4 years in Delhi. And I wasn't writing particularly well at that time in Delhi. So
Ruskin Bond lived in Delhi first, and then he moved to this beautiful hill station, Missouri, because he didn't find Delhi inspiring enough to write. So he's a writer. He was looking for the correct inspiration, and that inspiration he got in this hill station, which is Missouri. Ruskin Bond has written lots of lovely books for children. I'm sure you must have read at least a few. And his inspiration from this hill station is reflected in this short monsoon diary. He's talked about the monsoon season of Missouri. Now, what are monsoons? You must have read in social studies that monsoons are seasonal rains. India has 5 seasons, okay? So India has got summer, winter, autumn, spring, and monsoon season. Monsoon season is predominantly specific to Indian subcontinent, and monsoon season comes with rain. So Indian monsoons bring rain, and that monsoon season has been described in this diary. Now, what is diary entry? So let's understand the title first, right? We've understood the place he's going to write about. You saw the beautiful video of Missouri, and you see Ruskin Bond too. So he's the writer and the place. We've understood what monsoon is. Let's understand what diary is. Now, diary entry is for personal emotions, okay? In diary entry, you write as yourself, expressing your emotions. One of the most famous diaries is the diary of Anne Frank. Anne Frank wrote about her survival during the time of Hitler. She was a Jew and she survived during Hitler's reign, and she's written a lot about those experiences in her diary. So diary is the most personal form of writing which expresses your own emotions. So you will see that Ruskin Bond's diary starts with the description of mist. So before I begin the diary entry, I wanted to show you a picture of what mist looks like. You being in Kashmir are very, very, really aware of what mist is, right? So it happens on those cold, moist winter mornings that visibility is very less and the air is absolutely translucent. You can hardly see anything through. So this is Missouri and the misty weather there. As always, I will tell you why you should read this chapter. You should read this chapter so that you are inspired to read more of Ruskin Bond's book, to notice and appreciate the nature, to note the changes that monsoon brings in the environment. You will learn about the writer, you'll listen to the summary, you'll read the chapter and understand the lesson. Let's understand about the writer first. The writer is Ruskin Bond. He lives in the hill station Missouri in Uttarakhand. Now, Ruskin Bond is of English origin. That means he is from UK. But he settled in India. He lived his entire life in India. He's written 500 short stories, many novels. His half family is Indian. So he stays there with his family. I am sending you 2 videos which are Ruskin Bond's interviews. I'm sure you will enjoy them thoroughly. Please go through them. And that is one-to-one with Ruskin Bond. Now the story. You see, I'm sure you all know where Uttarakhand is. So I'll still show it to you in the map. Uttarakhand is a hill station. Mostly the entire area is hilly. A short monsoon diary is a set of diary entries by the writer. It follows the monsoon in Missouri and the changes it brings to the environment from the first day to the end of monsoon. So only the monsoon period. He talks about the silent miracles of nature. He begins by writing about the mist and how it hides everything, making the world seem silent and sad. When it is misty, do you feel like going out? No, when it is sunny, you feel like going out. So when it is misty, everything is very sad and you want to stay indoors. It's very silent. He talks about the appearance of seasonal plants. Take a look at these plants. When you read the chapter, you can hardly see everything. You can only imagine. So this is the cobra lily that he talks about. Tiger lily, sorry. And this is a fern, okay? He talks about lots of birds and insects which are seasonal visitors. The leopard, leeches, scarlet minivet and dronga. Ruskin Bond also describes these beautiful, lovely seasonal flowers also. Ground orchids, butterfly orchid, ladies' slippers and dahlias. So when you read the chapter, when you read it with me, you should imagine these beautiful colors when he writes about them. And he also talks about these seasonal visitors, the rodents and snakes. When it starts to flood, they all come out of their hiding and start entering the houses. The snake, the rodent and the shrew. Now let's read the chapter. So the monsoon rains in India move from south to north. So monsoon hits India in the beginning of June and this is Mussoorie. So it's come to Mussoorie on June 24th. So Ruskin Bond writes the first day of monsoon mist. So it's all misty and it's strange how all the birds fall silent and the mist comes climbing up the hill. So when it becomes misty, the entire world, the nature is silent. So that nature is silent because everything is so misty and you cannot see anything clearly. Perhaps that's what makes the mist so melancholy. What is melancholy? Melancholy is lonely. So when everything is so quiet, you feel lonely. So he says, it makes the mist so melancholy. So this is what? This is a transferred epithet. It means the feeling of humans are depicted through mist. Not only does it conceal the hills, it blankets them in silence too. So not only the visibility of the hills become less, the blanket of silence falls over hill. What does it mean? The birds, animals, everybody stops moving around and it becomes quiet. Okay? Only an hour ago the trees were ringing with bird songs. So he says before the mist came, the bird songs were sitting on the trees and singing and it was such a melodious sound. But all of a sudden, the melancholy mist, the mist that has made everyone quiet has come. And now the forest is deathly still as though it was midnight. So because of the mist, everything has become so quiet. Through the mist, Biju is calling his sister. So Ruskin Bond is seeing through his window and he can see that his worker, helper Biju is calling to his sister. I can hear him running about all the hillside. He's looking for his sister. But even Ruskin Bond can't see Biju because the mist is so heavy. But I cannot see him. This is the description of 24th June. Then come 25th June. Some genuine early monsoon rain, warm and humid and not that cold high altitude stuff we've been having all year. So Mussoorie is windy. It is beautiful, cold, fresh breeze blowing all the time in Mussoorie. But he's saying this is humid and warm. It is not like the high altitude wind that we have all year. I am sure you guys can relate to most of it because even the weather in Kashmir is quite like that. The plants seem to know it too. So in monsoon, many of the plants start blooming. So he's saying the coming of monsoon has been felt by the plants also. And the first cobra lily rears its head from the ferns. So rearing its head, what does it mean? Just like a cobra, the snake, it rears its head, raises its head. Similarly, this lily is also raising its head from the ferns. The mist affords a certain privacy. As I walk up to the bank and post office on my way, a schoolboy asked me, please describe the hill station and this valley in one sentence, a paradise that might have been. Ruskin Bond says it is as beautiful as paradise. It could have been a paradise, for all you ask me. he is comparing Mussoorie to paradise. So he's saying it is as beautiful as paradise. Thankfully, it is not paradise. It's on earth and we get to stay there. Right? So mist offers you privacy. That means when you're walking about, not everybody can see you all the time because the visibility is so less. The rains have heralded the arrival of some seasonal visitors, a leopard, several thousand leeches. You know, in humid places, there are lots of leeches. And for the leeches, I shall soon get used to a little bloodletting every day. What is bloodletting? When the leech sticks to you, it would suck out blood and then fall off. So many people in hilly places keep salt in their pockets. So the moment the leech sticks to them, they put salt over it and the leech would fall off. Otherwise, it only falls off when it has drunk enough blood from your body. So he's saying, I've gotten used to this bloodletting. There are so many leeches, they would come, they would drink, they would go. Okay. Now it is June 27th. Other new arrivals are the scarlet minivets. The females are yellow, flitting silently among the leaves like brilliant jewels. So they are so beautiful, they look like jewels. No matter how leafy the trees, these brightly colored birds cannot conceal themselves. Although by remaining absolutely silent, they sometimes contrive to go unnoticed. So these birds are so beautiful and bright like jewels. They may try to conceal themselves. Even the trees that have lots of leaves will not conceal them because they are so bright. Along come an unnecessarily aggressive pair of drongos chasing the minivets away. So Ruskin Bond is enjoying those minivets, the yellow beautiful birds. And then a pair of aggressive fighting drongos come and chases the minivets away. Yesterday afternoon, the leopard lifted a dog from near the servant's quarter below the school. So he's saying a leopard lifted a dog. So obviously leopards are looking out for chase hunts. Okay. In the evening, it attacked one of Biju's cows. So Biju's cow has been attacked. But you see, these people are used to these seasonal visitors. But what is the reaction? But fled at the approach of Biju's mother, who was screaming imprecations. So Biju's mother is not scared of the leopard. They are used to this. They know in monsoon the leopard will come and they have to save their domestic animals. So Biju's mother goes, excuse me, running and screaming all sorts of bad words at the leopard, and the leopard goes running away. A tree creeper moves rapidly up the trunk of the old tree. You see creepers and climbers mostly in monsoon. Even in Kashmir, you will see that the tree trunks are filled with creepers, beautiful green creepers. Snapping up insects all the way. Now that the rains are here, there is no dearth of food for the insectivorous birds. So there are many birds who eat insects for food. So there is no dearth of them. There are more and more insects in monsoon. In rains, you see, there are lots of insects around. Now it is August. We started from June. We have come to August. All night, the rain has been drumming on the corrugated tin roof. There has been no storm, no thunder, just the steady swish of a tropical downpour. It helps me to lie awake. At the same time, it doesn't keep me from sleeping. So Ruskin Bond is saying, the entire night it was raining. So there was no storm, no heavy winds, nothing. Basic tropical. India is a tropical country, so it was a basic tropical downpour, like the monsoon rains. It is a good sound to read by. How many of you enjoy? I really enjoy the sound of rain outside, a beautiful book in my hand, and a cup of coffee. Yeah, what more do you want in life? So he says it's a beautiful sound to read by, the rain outside, the quiet within. When it's raining outside, it hums, shushes all the sounds. So everything is quiet inside. All the tin roofs are given to springing, unaccountable leaks. There is a feeling of being untouched by and yet in rain with, touch with the rain. He says, the tin roofs are leaking so much, I have the feeling that I am safe from the rain also and in touch with the rain also, because the rainwater is coming through the roof. This is August 3. The rain stops. The clouds begin to break up to allow the sun. The sun strikes the hill on my left. In the oak tree, a crow shakes the raindrops from his feathers and caws inconsolately. So the crow is constantly cawing. The woman is chopping up sticks. I hear the tinkle of cowbells. So now, why is he describing all this? To let you know, once the rain has ceased, I can hear everything clearly. I can hear the sounds of nature. And suddenly, clean and pure, the song of the whistling thirst emerges like a dark sweet secret from the depths of the ravine. So a songbird has started singing and he can also listen to that. The hillsides are lush as late monsoon flowers begin to appear. Which are the monsoon flowers he's talking about? Wild balsam, dahlias, begonias and ground orchids. It is August 12th, endless and permanent mist. We haven't seen the sun for 8 or 9 days. So from 2nd or 3rd August, it has been 8 to 9 days. The author and the people in Mussoorie have not seen sun because constantly it's raining and there's a mist constantly around. Water drips from a leaking drain pipe, everything damp and soggy. When it rains constantly for so long, everything feels damp and soggy. Nowhere to go, pace the room, look out the window, at least a few bobbing umbrellas, at least it isn't cold rain. So he's saying at least the rain is not cold. That's one privilege. Other than that, everything is damp, soggy, you can't go anywhere. That's how it describes after 10 days of rain. So even though monsoon is beautiful, if it rains too heavily, everything starts becoming soggy and irritating. It is August 31st, it is the last day of August, and the lush monsoon growth has reached its peak. The seeds of the cobra lily are turning red, signifying that the rains are coming to an end. The seeds turning red means the monsoon is going to be over. So monsoon growth has reached its peak means everything is lush green because of the rain, but now it's going to end. And what signifies it? The cobra lily, its seeds turn red. In a few days, the ferns will start turning yellow, but right now they are still firm, green and upright. When do ferns turn yellow? When the autumn and then winter season is going to approach. And the white butterfly orchids put on a fashion display on the grassy slopes of Landore. Why do mauve, lady slipper and white butterfly orchids? These all flowers are so beautiful that it looks like a fashion display. Their colors are so vibrant, you feel like you are seeing a fashion show. So he's saying ground orchids, mauve lady slippers and white butterfly orchids, they put up a fashion show on the grassy slopes. Wild dahlias, red, yellow and magenta rear their heads from the rocky crevices. So inside the rocks, those small cracks are there. From there, wild dahlias, red, yellow and magenta have started rearing their heads. Now since it's rained so much, all these rodents, snakes and rodents that live in holes, their holes have been flooded because of the water. Now they are going into roofs and attics and godowns. A shrew weak of eyesight blunders about the room, much to the amusement of the children. So a shrew can't see anything, so it's roaming around in the room. If the rodents would see, they would hide. But this one can't see, so the children are enjoying. Don't kill it, admonishes their grandmother. Chuchunders are lucky, they bring money. So this is happening in whose quarter? Biju's quarter. So Biju's, the children's grandmother, Biju's mother says, do not kill the chuchunders. Chuchunders are considered to be lucky and they bring money. And sure enough, I receive a check in the mail, not a very large one, but welcome all the same. So he believes the fact that chuchunders are lucky, and Ruskin Bond believes that finally he's got a check that he must have been waiting for. Now it is October 3rd. We have gone straight from monsoon into winter rain. Snow at higher altitudes, even an evening hailstorm. What a hailstorm? Huge ice crystals falling from the sky. So that is hailstorm. So he's saying all of a sudden monsoon rain has turned into winter rain. So it's become cold also. Now it's January 26th. Winter rains in the hills. In the hushed silence of the house when I'm quite alone and my friend who was here has gone, it is very lonely, very quiet as I sit in a liquid silence, a silence within. Surrounded by the rhythm, liquid silence, why? Because it is raining outside. So the silence caused by liquid. See, appreciate the way Ruskin Bond is written. He's written so beautifully. Surrounded by the rhythm of rain, the steady drift of water on leaves, on lemons, on roof, drumming on drenched dahlias and window panes, while the mist holds the house in dark caress. What is caress? Holding it softly in your hands. So the mist is holding the house softly and there is liquid silence and I do feel lonely and very quiet. As I pause near a window, the rain stops and starts again. and the trees no longer green but grey menace me with their loneliness. So how he has reflected everything with the use of color. So he says the trees have become green and the grey, and that grey again gives me the feeling of loneliness. Now it is March 23rd. This is late March, so he's written from June to March. So June and August you see monsoon, then you see winters. Winters are melancholy and lonely. And then it is March and obviously it is spring, and spring is bright and beautiful. It's a very welcoming season. So it is spring now, late March, end of winter, winter is gone. The blackest cloud I've ever seen squatted over Mussoorie, and then it hailed marbles for half an hour, nothing like a hailstorm to clear the sky. Even as I write, I see a rainbow forming. So he's saying the blackest cloud appeared, then it hailed marbles what? He's comparing those ice crystals to marbles, and he's saying it hailed for half an hour and it cleared the sky and now I see a rainbow. So from monsoon, we've come to spring and beautiful rainbow season has come. I hope you enjoyed Ruskin Bond's short monsoon diary and you were able to picturize everything. If you couldn't see the pictures that I showed you in the video, and try to picturize the entire scene that Ruskin Bond has set for you and have fun while reading it. All the best, children. Thank you so much.